Welcome to MCN. Now this is MCN reader Craig. Hello mate.
Hi.
And this is his beautiful GSXR 750 K6. Now this is one of the best sports bikes money can buy. The best blend of power and handling. I think it's commonly known that is the case. This is a great bike. But it's getting a little bit old now and Craig wants to buy a different bike. So what should he buy? He doesn't want a 1000, too much. He doesn't want a 600, too revvy, too difficult to live with. So the only choices really is the new version of this, the K8 GSXR 750, or now there's the Ducati 848 as well. So let's go and have a quick look at these two bikes. Right, so this is the K8 GSXR 750, really similar to the K6 actually. Styling differences, obviously, but the engine makes the same amount of power and the architecture of the bike is very similar. What I'm worried about is that this isn't going to be a big enough step forward for Craig to really warrant spending another couple of grand upgrading his bike to this. But we'll see, we're going to have a ride of it in a minute. And then the other option here is Ducati's 848. This is like the baby 1098. Came out at the beginning of this year. It's a beautiful bike. Cost 9.5 grand compared to 8.2, which this is. But you do get a lot more quality with your price. Better suspension, really beautifully made. Just a lovely bike. What I am worried about, coming from a 750 to an 848 from Craig's point of view, the power delivery is quite flat, very torquey, completely different animal to the GSXR. So we'll see how he gets on with that one as well. And finally, just to make Craig's life a little bit more difficult choosing a bike, we've actually brought along a ZX10 and an R6 as well, just to make sure he doesn't actually want a 1000 or a 600. So we're going to go out on the roads, we're going to have a play around here at Bruntingthorpe, and we're going to speak to Craig later on today to see what his choice is. Okay, we've had a mega day, haven't we, in the sun?
Certainly.
And it's been the ultimate dealer test ride, really, isn't it? We've ridden your bike, the K8 750, the 848, ZX10, and the R6. And the original question was, what would you trade your bike up for, if anything?
Yeah.
So, what are your thoughts now?
Well, getting the 848 out, it's with the V-twin, it's definitely a different animal, unfortunately, than we're used to. It's didn't really suit the riding style I had across the roads. I felt it was a little bit stiff. As soon as you get up on the bike, it lurches you forward. Mm. Not really comfortable. I do a lot of long distance riding as well.
Yeah.
Big tour every summer. So, you know, for me, the Ducati, great for a weekend blast, I think. Around the track if you're used to a V-twin, but probably not for me.
Not to live with.
No.
And what about the K8? Is it better enough or good enough to tempt you away from your K6?
The K8, now having ridden it straight against mine, I found it a bit more refined, a little bit more comfortable. If I was into longer European trips, I think I'd go for the K8.
Yeah, over your bike.
Over my bike. The K6 has just got a little bit rawness still there. So I might save the money and tinker around with mine, possibly.
At the end of the day, you're going to have to spend about £2,000, I guess, something like that, to go from K6 to K8. And is it worth £2,000 more?
It buys you a lot of goodies, doesn't it?
Yeah, so you could put some different gearing on your bike.
Yep.
You know, bling it up a little bit. So, and what about the 600 and the 1000? Has that
600.
Kind of confirmed the fact you don't want those bikes?
I'm happy with the level of power that I'm riding, the bikes I'm riding. The 600, take it around the roads, it needs ringing around the neck.
Yeah. It's a track bike, isn't it?
It is. It is, yeah. You've just got to get it in there on the track. 1000, as I've always suspected, just a bit too much for me on the roads.
Yeah.
I like to sort of open the throttle and ride, you know, at comfortable speeds I'm comfortable with.
Yeah.
But the 1000cc just makes me a little uncomfortable.
Especially the ZSN is an animal, isn't it? It's always on the verge of tank slapping and a bit lively, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
So really, the 750 is still the bike to go for, but not necessarily the K8. So really, I suppose the answer to the question is, if you can't stretch to a K8, a K6, or even I'd say a K4 or 5, GSX-R 750 is still a mega bike to go for. If you can stretch to a K8, it's worth it because of the refinements there.
Yeah.
But the 750 is a great all-round package, isn't it?
It's fantastic. Yeah.
Well, thanks for coming, mate.
Thanks very much.
Thanks a lot, mate.
Great day.
See ya.